This is the 8th and final video in the tutorial series where we make this animation with a Blender Python script. Hi, I'm Victor Stepanov. I'm so excited to see you in the final video for this series. Let's see what's coming up. This part is all about producing the same animation with less code. We're going to start off by installing a Python package that we'll be using throughout this video. Next, one by one, we'll replace most of our helper functions with the functions from this Python package. As always, you can find the code we'll be starting off with in the GitHub page for this series. Look for Start Code in the description. I'll add the code that we'll have at the end of this video right underneath that. We'll need to install a special add-on that'll add most of our helper functions into the Blender Python. I'll add a link into the description under BPY Building Blocks Add-on. Or you can go into any browser and type in cgpython.com/bpybb and hit enter. This will redirect you straight to the latest release page of this add-on. Once you're on the release page, go to the very bottom and into Assets and download the zip archive. As soon as that's ready, go into Blender, go into Edit, Preferences, and then Install. Navigate to where you downloaded the zip archive, hit Install, and make sure to click this checkbox to enable the add-on. Now to test that you've installed this correctly, go into the scripting workspace, and in the interactive Python console, type in import bpybb and hit enter. This should not produce any errors and it should import successfully. You could also check where this module is coming from by typing in bpybb __path__, and it should be located where the default location of where your add-ons will be installed for Blender. Now that we have our building blocks package installed, let's start replacing our helper functions with the functionality in that package. But before we do that, let's hide the HDRI setup we worked on in a previous video. Now let's go to the very top of our editor and right underneath the imports, write the following. With this import statement, we're adding this function to our script. We're not using it yet. Let's make sure that we're importing something that exists. So if I run the script, you could see that it's successfully executed. And for example, if I make a typo and add numbers right here, this doesn't exist, so it's gonna give me an error. As you can see, it's reporting that, hey, this thing that you just typed in doesn't exist. So I'm just gonna remove that. So we are importing a function that exists in this Python package. Let's go to the location where we're gonna be replacing this function. Hit Control F, and then let's search for set scene. And you should find the set scene props function. And at the very bottom, you'll find the set square resolution. Now I'll add the function that we just added by pasting in the name and add a comment, a hash sign right before that so Python ignores it for now. The function that we're replacing is used to set the resolution of a camera each time we run our script. For example, if I set the output resolution to something else, like go into the output settings and set this to some numbers that are not 1080 by 1080, I'll run this script and you'll see that the resolution gets set by 1080 by 1080 right back. If I comment this function out and set to some random values, run the script again, you'll see that it's finished, but it didn't reset the resolution of the image. Let's uncomment the function that we just added and add two parentheses at the end. So we're calling this function now. And let's run our script. As you can see, it reset the resolution. Now that this function is replaced, let's remove the code of the helper function. So I'm gonna select this, go into this find and replace, just gonna paste the name in, and then hit find. Make sure that you have this wrap set up. Here's the function. I'm going to select and remove all this code, and let's run the script again to make sure that everything's running. And yes, the successfully finished, so that's good. I'm going to click find again, so we're going to go back here where we're replacing this helper function. I'm going to remove this as well. Now let's remove our next helper function. Let's go to the very top of our script and write the following import statement. Let's make sure that this function exists by running our script. Right, we successfully executed our script. That means that Python was able to find this function. Let's find the location where this function is used. As you can see right here, this is the definition of this function. We don't need it anymore since we're importing this function from our package. We won't need purge orphans as well because it's getting called only from the clean scene function. So I'm going to just delete all this. And I'm going to run our script. As you can see, it's successfully executed. Now let's see what this function is actually doing. I'm going to paste in the find inner place and find the location where this function is getting executed. So it's right here in the setup scene function. If we don't execute this function, we'll continue to get more and more objects in our scene. So we need to run it before we start adding anything new. So we'll have a blank slate to work with. I have a whole separate video on this particular function explaining all the details of what's happening. So check that out if you're interested. Now let's remove our next helper function. Let's go to the very top of our script and add following import statement. This is the apply HDRI helper function, and we're going to be replacing the function that we created in the previous video. Let's run the script to make sure that this function exists. As you can see, it does. It didn't give us any errors, any import errors. Now let's go find our apply HDRI function that we're going to be replacing. I'm going to copy this and go into the find and replace and find the definition. So we don't need all of this code right here, so I'm just going to scroll all the way down. And I'm just going to select all of this and delete it. Now, if I run our script, we're going to still have our HDRI getting applied. Let's continue our cleanup by going to the top of the script again and adding the following import statement. All right. These two helper functions is apply material and make color ramp from a color list. Let's run the script to make sure that this exists. All right, Python was able to find these functions. That's good. Now let's find the locations of the helper functions we're going to be replacing these with. I'm going to copy the name of this function and search for setup material. And then click find, and this should find the definition of the setup material function. We're going to be replacing this make color ramp from colors, slightly different name than what we're importing from our Python package. That's okay. We're just going to find that and delete it in just a minute. I'm going to add a hash character and paste in the name of the function that's going to be replacing this. To illustrate, I'm going to open the shader editor once more. By dragging here on the left and opening the shader editor right here. So this is the color ramp that we're talking about. This is the color ramp that's getting modified by this function right here. And if I comment this out, this will be just a plain color ramp with just two colors. I'm going to run the script right now. And as you can see, there's only black and white. And nothing's getting added. This right here was setting up this color ramp with the colors from our color palette. I'm gonna copy these parameters right here and then paste them right here to the second function, the one that we just added. I'm going to uncomment this and I'm going to run our script. And as you can see now, we got our colors back. So this thing that we just imported is now working. Let's find the code for this helper function by copying this and pasting it into the find and replace. Click find. And here's the definition right here. I'm just going to select all this and delete. All right, let's run the script again to make sure that everything's working. Yes, it is. And let's go back by hitting the find next again and just delete this code that we don't need anymore. Now let's go to the very top again of our script and look for the apply material. The problem is that when I was creating the material setup video, I totally forgot to use this. So we're gonna add it where it should be. We're gonna copy this and we're gonna search for gen perlin. This should find the definition of the genPerlin function. And right here, instead of having this convoluted curve object data materials append, we're just going to replace this with apply material. And again, let me show you how this works. I'm going to comment this out and I'm going to run our script. And as you can see, there's no material getting applied to our shape. I'm going to go back, control space again. I'm going to uncomment this function and run it. Well, actually, before I do that, we have two definitions of this now. So one is coming from our module and one is actually in this file. So before I run the script, let me delete that code. So I'm going to paste in the name, apply material, find next. So it's going to find the first one, the one that we just imported, and find again. It's going to find this definition that I forgot to use in the material setup video. So I'm going to delete that. And let's find this again. And now we're here again, where we're using our material, apply material function. I'm going to run the script. And as you can see now, we have our material back on our shape. All right, let me hide the shader editor again. And I'm gonna go to the very top of the script again and import our next helper function. Let's run our script. This is the time seed function. It's a whole separate topic that I won't have time to go in this particular video. But the mental model you can use for now is this function helps us set a new seed based on the current time. So every single time we're running our script, it generates a new seed instead of setting it by hand, right? It just uses the current time and allows us to get a new shape every time. Let's see where this function is used. I'm just gonna copy the name, paste and find it. So it found the definition right here. We don't need that for now. We're going to go into the setup scene function definition. And right here we have our setup for our seed. For now, by default, this is set to 0. And this means that this gets evaluated to false and we use the time seed. So if you look at our shape, I'm going to run our script. And every time we get a new shape here, right? If I set this to something like, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, every single time I run the script, we're gonna get the same shape. So I'm just gonna continue to run. And as you can see, we've pinned down the seed and now we're getting the same shape, the same colors and everything, every single time we run it. So I'm gonna set this back to 0. Instead of doing this by hand, like setting 1, 2, or like every single time we run it, we're just gonna let Python just take the current time and use that as the seed. Let's find a definition for this function. It's right here. And as you can see, we're getting the time, getting the seed, setting the seed, right? And also it's a, there's a nice feature where we copy this to the clipboard. If I run this, and I'm just gonna paste whatever is in my clipboard, it gave me this number right here. This gets added right here from the generated seed. So I'm gonna delete that. And since we don't need this anymore because we're importing from our Python package, our building blocks Python package, we can delete all this. Also notice it's using the time module right here. I'm gonna delete that as well. Right here, we're importing it, right? I'm gonna delete this definition, and I'm gonna delete this time import. And now I'm gonna run our script to make sure again that there are no errors and our script runs. All right, that looks good. It looks like we're running and there are no issues. If you're learning something new or just enjoying this video, make sure to like this video. It'll help me tremendously. Let's add our final batch of helper functions. And let's run our script to make sure that we're importing existing functions. All right, so we're adding an active object helper function, track empty, and apply location. Let's find the definitions for these functions. I'm just going to search for this. Right here, that's the definition. Let's see where it's used. We have add the control empty. We have the setup camera, getting the camera. We have the getting the circle after we've added the primitive circle in the gen Perlin curve. After we convert our mesh to a curve, we get the curve object. And yeah, we get the bevel. So as you can see, it's used in a number of places. Since we're now importing it from our building blocks package, we don't need this function definition right here. So I'm just gonna remove that. Now let's find the track empty. I'm gonna select that, paste this. And here is the function definition. This function helps us set up our camera to track an empty. So we're looking at a particular place in the scene. I'm just gonna remove this and let's see where it's getting added. As you can see, it's in the setup camera function right here. We're using it and that is the track empty function. And apply location. I'm gonna copy this, paste this right here. And here's the definition, we don't need that. I'm gonna remove this and find the next location. And again, it's in the gen Perlin curve function. Remember when we're trying to stack our curves, we needed to apply the location. So here it is getting used. And since we deleted the definition, now we're using this function right here coming from the BPY building blocks package. Now let's run our script to make sure that everything's working. All right, now looks like everything's working.
Let's take a look at how many lines we removed. In our previous version, we had almost 600 lines. Now, just over 340.
Thank you for joining me on this Python tutorial series. I hope you learned something. See you next time.